I hear a lot of people attributing God's judgment to people or nations when we're in a time of grace. Hallelujah. Now I hear that often. I hear, well, you know, especially with New Orleans, you know, because New Orleans is known for its sinful practices.
Yes, sir.
And when the floods came in and destroyed the place, many people to this day say it was God.
Mm-hmm. Say the same thing by hate.
But it's not. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. People are assuming, yep, because of their indoctrinization, because of their upbringing, yep, they're assuming God to be something the Bible is not saying He is.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
There
is coming a day of judgment. Thanks be ready. Mm-hmm. Please don't misunderstand me. If you sin, you will suffer. Mm-hmm. I'm not preaching that. I'm not preaching that you won't suffer. You will suffer.
Yes, sir.
You'll suffer at the hand of the devil because you played into the hands of the devil.
Yes, right, right, yes.
But the problem is that if you don't repent, then you'll really suffer at the hands of a just God.
Amen.
Because there is a day of that coming. It's
yes,
not
yes,
yet here, but it's coming.
Yes,
right
yes,
now, Jesus took all
yes,
your judgment.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank
you,
Lord.
Thank
you, Jesus. However, if you refuse His grace, mm-hmm, there's waiting a time of judgment. I don't want to be misunderstood on that today.
Mm.
But in this present hour, you are under grace.
Thank you, Lord.
Can you say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
That's why you can sin and nothing immediate happens.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Lord God.
When Adam and Eve sinned, it happened.
Yeah.
When the people in the Old Testament sinned, things happened.
Yeah.
But today, we can sin and sin for years. And nobody knows.
God knows.
And people eventually do. You know, God is just a little bit off of it, but God is such a gentleman in that He will deal with you individually,
mm-hmm, right,
and try to correct you.
Mm-hmm.
And in that attempt to correct you, if you still don't hear, He's going to send someone to you.
Yes,
not a group, but He'll send someone, maybe one or two people to you, to minister to you and try to shake you out of it and help you. If you still don't surrender to Him, then you're going to be humiliated in front of a people, a lot of people. So the key is stop at the beginning. Don't let it get that far. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Well, the fourth thing is Bible interpretation that I hear way off base. Reading a passage one way, and because they've been taught that, or their upbringing was that way, or their denomination stands that way, then they just assume that it has to be the correct way. And that assumption will keep you from some life.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Hallelujah. You know, I used to think, how could these great men that did great works, that they were teaching things that I didn't know was right or wrong, and I'm trying to decide if they're right or wrong, how could they possibly be wrong? They've got doctorates miles long behind their name, they spent their life studying it, they're so much more into it than I could ever be, how could I possibly say they're not right?
Yeah.
And in the natural, that would be correct.
Yeah.
But the problem is, you can study it from your mind, or you can study it from your heart.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And the one from the mind can have a boatload of titles.
Yeah.
And know some truth.
Mm-hmm.
But because they've never experienced,
mm-hmm,
spiritual things, they're only limited to what they can tell. So then they misinterpret a gross amount of this book because it's a spiritual book.
Yes.
So therefore, their followers do the same thing.
Yep.
Look at 2 Peter, back in 2 Peter chapter 1. Verse 20 says, knowing this first.
Yes.
that no prophecy of the Scripture is of any private interpretation.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's not of one man or one denomination or one church group to say, the Lord is the Lord of the Word.
Mm-hmm.
His Holy Spirit will give us the correct and sane interpretation. But it must be from the Spirit and not man's wisdom.
Yeah.
Man is smart. Man is very... Anybody that can put these people on the moon and bring them back like they do, to me, is just amazing.
Oh, yeah.
I marvel when I cross the Skyway Bridge.
Yeah.
That man could build such a structure and we could travel on it.
That's right.
And not fall into the ocean.
Oh, yeah.
Man is smart.
Yes, they are.
But this is not about smart. This is about knowing God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Be more smart.
Let me tell you another one, assumption that knocks people off course.
Uh-oh.
Romance.
Oh.
How many young people I have seen get on fire for God, and then somebody, male or female, comes in, and boom.
Yep.
They're knocked right off. They assume it's a
winner.
Well, not just in romance, but how about business?
Yep.
How can an unbeliever and a believer go into business together? You can't. Because what you're wanting to do, being led by the Spirit, the unbeliever is going to be at odds with
you. That's right.
Tithing, for instance. Oh, no. We need that money.
Yep.
We've got to use that money. That's what they would say.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Unequally yoked. You find that in 2 Corinthians 6:14. We won't go there because I'm running out of time. Next thing is misunderstanding assumptions of sickness and disease. Countless times I hear and have heard people say, God put this on me.
Not my fault.
Now, you're in a church that we teach against that, so it's kind of foreign to you, but you don't kid yourself. Outside these doors,
all the time.
Quote, Christian people think God is doing this for some reason to them.